Alright, so we're just rocking grand finals. After a heartbreaking set against Snap, your boy, Rockabo here.
Got some with... brawler here, defeated by Rockabo. And
we're gonna see where this goes.
They actually played earlier.
They did.
And I commentated.
What did Turbo play in?
That's it. Pulled out the Ice Climbers, and it was disgusting.
It was just super messy.
I like saying Nap is really good, but damn, those Ice Climbers tore him apart.
Well, Nap coming off playing sets with Marth, so it's kind of hard to but Turbo's pressure is looking pretty crisp right now. Reverse fair, all right, let's go. He's just sort of covering the space. That's kind of how you have to play it on this stage, because you want to get the grabs, right? Because you have the space to do it. But, like, Falco will just... The concept is just for Falco to retreat the platform. So you just have to capitalize on that. And, dear God, that should have killed. But, pretty good.
Marth is kind of dangerous on stages with platforms.
Yeah, it's just this stage in particular, it's kind of hard for Marth to recover. And, great... Of course, it is also hard for, you know, Falco to recover, but it's very much a camping thing. Also, that was a very interesting circumstance. I feel like Nap actually should have had that, like, a bit earlier with the missed up B, but it was just good enough to get out of range there. But trading stocks, we're back to about even.
Pretty close.
This stage... Yeah, it has its moments where it's kind of like it's polarizing in one direction, but it's only that obvious when you see like Falco start like really camping. That's just not how Nap tends to play. And of course, Turbo capitalizing on this with his insane punish game right now, definitely showing a little bit of that shine of that Peach coming through in his Marth right now.
Just making sure he can punish Eddie for the little things he does.
Of course, spacey aggression really good a lot of the times. So, you know, but Eddie finding some nice little openings here and there. But it is very, very hard when you're just pressured down and like covered that hard. You make some risky decisions. But pretty good coverage there. Yeah, knock him far enough away from the ledge. Marth's up B is not exactly the greatest recovery tool in the game. In fact, it might even be one of the worst. But like. You know, of the top tiers. Between Marth and Falcon, it's pretty close, I would say, in terms of bad recovery.
Got a couple up tilts there.
Nice shine back air, looking like West Balls right now.
I wish I knew more of the melee stuff. I'm doing my best, guys.
I don't know, you'll be fine. It just takes some time.
But Eddie on the offensive, and looks like he can clinch this.
Yeah, that was very good coverage at the platform there. Just being perfectly aware of where Turbo wants to move, and that's very important because, you know, identifying where your opponent wants to camp is very, very much like a good thing in your favor, and starts to turn the neutral in your favor, because if Turbo's just going to sit around at a platform, He's just gonna look for an opening on that platform to take it. But double fair off stage, very clean. Still pretty close, to be honest with you. Not the greatest, because having a 75% lead is kind of catastrophic if he gets one shine. But this, of course, is Marth versus Spacey's, and anything can happen.
What's the consensus? How does Marth do against
Spacey's? Depends on the stage. This is not exactly the best stage for the matchup, but I can't say that it's impossible or something like that. Probably a good like 55-45 in favor of Falco on this stage. But you see some pretty crazy things like covering the platform like that, and a nice tipper F smash. Very, very clean. Very, very good start. 1-0 up.
It's
very, very, very solid. Real rep, Eddie just thought that was game two. this looks like it could be pretty I mean, last match took a lot out of him, I would say. It definitely felt like he was starting to go on limits there. Turbo just sort of going in with Marth and doing what he knows best, and exploiting what sort of like insecure things Nap likes to do. Now he is starting to play a little bit more defensive, sort of being more aware that he can be in shield and get away. But this is the kind of tech chase I'm talking about. This is a stage where a lot of people actually think, believe it or not, it's kind of contested, but a lot of people actually think Marth has the advantage on spaces on the stage. As, you know, you can kind of tell there. That was very, very crisp. Looking absolutely solid.
But, yeah, I would definitely agree with that at this point, because this is a pretty
solid lead. I mean, here's the thing. So, obviously, in base stage, this looks absolutely absurd and definitely in Marth's favor. The stuff where things get kind of tricky, it's like, oh yeah, because if we were to take this to a situation where this was the only, like, position, right, it would be very, very cleanly in Marth's favor, because the platforms are low-hanging enough that you get up tilt very cleanly, and like, most characters really get a lot of benefits out of the platform heights and just the ceiling heights and the sort of things you can do, but when transformations get factored in, that's where, like, a lot of the discussion gets tricky. Because, yeah, alright. So, I say a lot of good things about Marth on this stage, but, like, you can... This is, like, the kind of point where you start camping and, like, sort of coming back in, waiting on the transformation, is sort of like a reset to neutral, regaining control. And it can be kind of hard when you're facing a Falco and laser is an option, because they can just sort of laser camp sitting on a platform, and then you have to come back to that. It's kind of difficult because you're in a position where you need to like figure out a way to regain control of neutral. But yes, looking very good.
Trying to mitigate some of that early advantage Turbo got.
Yeah, but Nap definitely looking a lot smarter with how he's placing stuff out. I feel like going to Dreamland Game 1 might have actually been a little bit of stake. He sort of assumed that he would have enough space, but a space isn't necessarily what he needs. He needs the ability to, like, just have space to think and, like, immediately follow up when he needs to follow up, instead of, like, potentially risking, like, dying really early to a Marth gimp. But this is just the sort of thing where he has to get like, a good shine, a good nair in neutral or something like that. Just find an opening, and that's pretty good place to start. Oh, very solid back air. Reading that attempt to stall above the ledge, above the stage, probably not the best choice, but it was worth a shot. He's getting a little nervous though, because I recognize those air dodges. Trying to go for that down smash aerial kill, I think, because he was trying to go for the ceiling there. Ooh, good down tilt. And good ledge grab. Back in there. Even again. Honestly, between like the three of us, like I know I'm kind of just circle jerking myself a little bit, but between the three of us, I feel like it's always so close, and just watching sets like this, this is just like super helpful for all of us. And wow.
Well, Nap got off a lot on that transformation back.
Yeah, because he
got a lot of stuff off the wall there.
So, yeah, so the one thing they tell you not to do is do the cliff battle. Because you don't go down there, Jeff. You don't want to go down there. You don't want to fight on the cliff, because when you have a character like Falco that can wall jump, it's very, very difficult.
I'm afraid of the wall jump down there.
So they're going to Fountain. This is a pretty good choice. I actually probably should have gone here in my attempt to run back to try to make things work out, but honestly, I was going to have to go to Dreamland in that set anyway. So showing that going to Dreamland is a bad idea to Nap is sort of forcing some little problems, as we can tell.
If I'm wrong, wouldn't this stage be better for Marth? Is it better for space?
Oh, this particular stage? This particular stage is ridiculous for Marth. So the reason it's so ridiculous is that are those two moving platforms on the left and right. The variable platforms offer a couple different things. So
we can get tilts off.
You already know about ledge canceling, right? So when you go at the ledge there, you can actually like automatically like cancel out of an aerial and do another aerial or some other attack. And the way this benefits Marth is double fair in a lot of matchups. Oh, it is really crazy. But the other thing is, you can, because of how Mars Grab works, because, you know, everyone knows how absurd Mars Grab works, but did you know it grabs on when someone's on that platform? If that that left platform right there, Marth can actually grab a fair amount of the cast on that platform. It is absolutely nuts. And in this particular like matchup of Spaceys, it's just kind of like you get a lot of free up tilts, you get a lot of free like aerial covers, and the sides are really short. Spaceys have a sort of secret little fear where they do not want to be in very, very small side stages.
Good stock by Gilman right there. He got a lot off in the air and just kept a solid edge guard in the time.
Yeah, that's the little Mars special. Get that clean juggle, find a way to send him off on the side for the kill on Fountain. It is...
See, stuff like that's why I don't like the Mars.
Oh yeah, it is really hard, and wow, that forward tilt. Cool. Okay. He was going a little head. He thought that the up B was gonna go up above the ledge, which fair argument. He's getting in there. Good ledge grab by Eddie. Very, very aware of what's going on. Trying to get himself back in there. Very tricky though when you're kind of eating that down tilt. Oh, went a little early on the fair there. Getting that F tilt though, much better.
There it is.
Turbo is definitely getting back in there. These sort of stages, it's very clear like how crazy the punish is. It's really difficult for Spaceys to get a lot off on the switch. Like it looks bad for Falco because like a lot of Falco's problems come from having the vertical kill, and of course this stage has a really high ceiling, which doesn't help very much. But even a character who has maybe less of a bad time because it's still a pretty strong character in vertical, even on this high ceiling stage, like
Eddie,
Fox,
Eddie
still very problematic. Yeah, he's trying to find some openings right now. Get in there. He's got a percent lead, but again, very easy for Marth to just find a little aerial entrance way there. Good grab. Nair. Oh, that was a very nice wait on that Nair, actually. Going for that up tilt. He's trying to cover the option. Good. Very good. Possibly would have tried to do the Mewtwo King ledge guard there, right, just
so
in case he went too far. But it's 2-1
turbo.
Yeah, 2-1 turbo. Looking pretty good. My guess is that they're probably going to go to either Yoshi's or Battlefield.
I feel like,
but
Yoshi's,
I'm not
be a better choice for Eddie, right?
But I guess they're running it back to Dreamland. All right. I don't know. I feel like Turbo demonstrated that he has a pretty good knowledge of how to play Marth on this stage. But like, you know, some things change, and you're adapting in the set and trying to make things happen. So Eddie trying to make something work. I can understand it. I can respect it. It's just kind of tricky when you know you're getting followed up like this. Very clean grabs, but very aware of what's going on. Looking like my boy Crescent Monkey with just the weight and then going in for the grab.
Oh my gosh.
The three jabs to forward throw. Alright. Answering right back with grab. Ooh!
That was sexy.
Dare covering the ledge. Very solid. Much more aware this time from Nap on this end. Of course, we're getting those pillar combos going right now. Up B to get out of the combo. That was alright. Very reasonable decision. Oh, get that jab. Oh, the back air?
Oh,
that was so nice. That was like a Mewtwo King edge guard, man. Like, I feel like it could have been more stylish, but, you know, that's like one of the 1001 ways Mewtwo King edge guards with Marth. And that's like, there's another example. Ooh! All right, feeling himself right now. This is looking pretty nasty. I don't know if I don't know, but if I'm Eddie right now, I'm a little nervous. That was pretty sick, actually.
I'm going back to Dreamland, probably wasn't the best decision.
No, he's doing all right. He's covering the options. He's got to get back in there. And one of the good ways to get back in there is just sort of like. Reading Turbo's patience is something he's been starting to do, and I've noticed that. It's helpful to, like, when somebody's starting to just become more patient to your aggression, to, like, start having more tactical aggression.
That was so hard.
So he's being a lot more smart with when he's putting out his aerials, which is like, you know, he's going for later hits and stuff like that, and that's a lot safer. All right. So, starting to go for some interesting little mix-ups with side B there. Covering air with forward air is very good because it makes Eddie have to retreat and start doing lasers, which is fine because Turbo will take that by just going through a platform to avoid them. But very aware down smash of the dash in there. Looking like it could maybe go to game 5, but I mean, you know, it's anybody's game, and Marth can just do absolutely, oh my god. Was he really going to try to go for the reverse? I would have lost my shit if he had actually gotten that reverse. I would have really lost it if he got the reverse. Eddie started to feel himself, but like here comes the grab, man. Oh, he's going for up tilt. Well, the tricky thing is the other reason that I feel like this matchup's really tricky for Marth on this stage, despite the fact that I was sort of like, you know, Gilman showing he knows what he's doing. It's really hard for Marth to kill on Dreamland. I mean, that was probably pretty obvious, but like up tilt did not kill off the ceiling at 148. Well, that is not a good thing.
As you said in the past, not stream, but you know, you said when Marth gets things to high percentages, he has a harder time getting.
Yeah. So your choice tree actually goes down a lot more because there are only so many moves you actually want to put out that are safe and can possibly get you a kill. Like, or at least get you another confirm into a kill. Super risky going for that back air. He's trying to go to game 5 here. Oh, just didn't space the. Oh,
flubbed the
recovery reset there. Planning on going for game 5. I think it's. This seems like it's.
Smash 4 over. 2-1. Did it go to game 5? Holy shit.
So it looks like they're going to go to Yoshi's here. It's tied game 5.
What just happened?
This is still pre-reset, yeah, it's game 5.
Set count is currently 2 for Gilman and 1 for Nat.
2-2.
2-2?
He got the kill of the Dreamland. On the Dreamland reset. So this stage, I've talked about this like maybe like last semester just randomly before we had a stream. I feel like this stage is like one of the most entertaining stages to play this matchup on, just simply because like you just destroy each other. It's like playing Falcon Marth on, but like between like Marth and a Spacey, which makes no sense, but it's just entertaining to watch.
Oh my.
Because the platforms are just perfect heights for both of these particular characters. It's also very good for a character, you know, such as Fox. Heck, to be honest with you, and I know you're not a huge fan of this stage, it's actually pretty good for Sheik too. There, you get some pretty good like short hop bears coverage of the platform and everything like that. I actually really like this stage in this game, despite being more of a Battlefield guy.
Well, I mean, it's a good stage. I loved it when I played Ganondorf, but you know, part of the reason why I don't play it very often is because I end up with crap like this, Marth or Spacey, and they absolutely destroy Sheik on this stage.
He's trying to cover the low recovery, going for that up air. Yeah, see, so even here, Marth struggles a lot, and you got, that was 177, like,
it was pretty up there.
Eddie got a free 56 on that, and it took a while, even when Turbo ended up winning the neutral there, just to get in there. Nice safe recovery on Randall. They're trying to pressure him on Randall to make him risk himself there. A little too far with the roll to go for that first F smash, but that second F smash gets the confirm. Looking like Nap's trying to get back in there, maybe get that reset. But here comes a juggle. Like every time, this is just something I've also noticed with Eddie. It feels like. And with a lot of people, really, it feels like there are certain grabs that people are able to react to really well, but like that, then you watch like a good Spacey like get grabbed, and a lot of times you're sort of like, oh well, they have pretty decent DI and everything like that. I feel like they're one of the only things I've ever had an issue with Eddie with in matchups like this is that he just picks really weird or like no DI for any sort of grab and grab to throw. He'll just like he'll get chain grabbed for a while because he doesn't make the decision to do it like straight away and be more mindful of it. So you'll see like Gilman get a lot of free percent. Another save by Randall, very good there. But at the same time, like I'm seeming to become more aware of it. It's just it feels like in this matchup in particular, it's really problematic for him. Nice late hit up air, very very good when it's late hit. Early hit is probably one of the weakest moves in the game, actually. But Knapp's starting to feel himself, getting that up tilt. He's getting in there. I probably should have just gone to the next platform and got sort of read the fall with an up tilt because he wasn't going for anything. But nice shine back air. Again, look at... Oh!
I like it.
That is the reset. And well, I gotta say...
We are going to Grands of the bracket reset.
I gotta say, like... I know this is big. I know I've been saying that some bad stuff about the dude recently, but like that was so mango it hurts. That was so mango it hurts. Oh my god, just the going in there.
Oh boy. Gilman,
all right.
Gilman going fox.
Yep, Gilman whipping out the fox, whipping out that sick fox.
I don't think I've ever seen Gilman's fox.
Have you really not? It is probably one of the crazier characters he has. Like, those two characters, Fox and Marth, have been what he's been seeing a lot of success with. But it's kind of like I said, I feel like, despite like how nervous I think Knapp probably actually was, like, this matchup is something he's possibly more used to than, like, Falcon Marth. But even then, he got some, Marth practice prior, so I felt like, despite Turbo doing better on stages I didn't do so well hot on, there was a lot of, wow.
Was a nice down
air. See, this is the kind of matchup where, like, if a win in neutral means a whole bunch. Just like Marth versus a Spacey, there you obviously have to worry about like grabs from Fox because Fox's grab can chain grab Falco, and it's not a very pleasant thing to experience. I'm kind of interested in if Turbo is actually going to go to FD in this matchup. Because, you know, the other problem is, on the other side of the spectrum, Falco absolutely wrecks fastfallers. It is very interesting.
Both Falco and Fox are fastfallers.
Well, yes. Which is part of the reason it's very significant. Fox, Falco, and Sheik have a really, really rough time with Falco combos.
Wow! That was very surprising.
I've seen this sort of reaction from Turbo before. This is where you sort of like turn it up, but like this could also be like really really problematic for the rest of the set.
I know how it feels to get, you know.
Look! Oh my god! He was. It looked cool. It looked cool. I know it was never going to work, but it looked cool. It definitely looked cool. Going for that. Oh, reading the high up B with the up tilt, still just sort of trying to find his way back in. Oh, the dare! Oh my god! It was a really good angle, actually. This is really, really rough.
Well, I'm just curious. Why do you think Turbo switched to Fox? Because, I mean, maybe it was because he was... His Marth didn't get beat, but...
In my opinion, from my whenever I've played the Turbo and, like, various things, it's sort of like a tilt counter. You sort of want to... He wants to avoid putting himself in a position where he just flubs everything, doesn't really want to do well with the character, and feels like there's a chance somebody could, like, get in the head there. And since the set was reset, it's an opportunity for him to like start over with a different character and see where it goes and make Eddie have to adapt to this different character. Yeah. Problem is that it's Fox. And like I said, this matchup is something that Falcos can get super used to really quickly. Because it's just a matter of trading back and forth, but this time much more at what Falco wants to play, a much more aggressive pace when he doesn't have to laser camp. And like I said, Falco and Fastfallers do not get along very well because of the crazy strings you can get. On the other hand, you know, obviously Fox still pretty decent against Fastfallers, very good against floatier characters. So you could almost say that's where their contrasts sort of lie, that that make a huge difference here. And more than likely, despite the fact that I feel like it would be a pretty good opportunity for Turbo to play something like a Peach or whatever, it's not exactly the best decision for him. If he wants to see like improvement, he wants to get better in this particular matchup. Because it's not necessarily a terrible matchup to play. It's actually one of the most fun matchups in the game. But you have to really be aware of what you're doing and respect your opponent like at all times. And like almost in, like a frame instead of a second. Like, they're trying to cover each other's options really, really well. And, you know, that grab, very good.
Turbo's done a very good job of keeping his momentum. And he's been punishing Eddie pretty hard.
He's regaining control where he was having a... where he lost that in Dreamland Game 1. Eddie's still keeping it close, obviously, but, like...
This isn't too much of a deficit. He can still come back with this.
Oh, yeah, I mean, there's a lot to be... to go for here. Oh, probably meant to drop down the ledge there, but it's okay. We take those, I guess. Oh, not if just sort of the nervous roll back. He's definitely covering all the options. Oh, the air dodge. That made me really nervous, really, because like that is not a good look.
Oh my.
Good fade back with the second up B to stall there. Oh, almost going for that disrespect shine there, but. Wasn't even really necessary because of the fast fall. Alright, good grab. This is kind of where, like, Fox has to do his thing here. And I think on this particular stage, like, in this matchup, this matchup is very much decided on, like, what stages, like, mains of the character prefer. Like, this looks like a stage that Turbo's actually pretty comfortable with Fox on. But, It can be very much more in favor of a Falco player who's possibly used to the transformations a lot more and getting in there and stuff like that. But camping with Fox is pretty easy. It shouldn't be hard when waiting out a transformation like this. And of course, both these characters can wall jump, kind of nice. So you could see some pretty cool things if they decide to have a pit fight like that. Very risky though, because of things like you can get like jab up smash off of like knocking him off a wall or something like that. Of course, looking very close. Right, honestly, one shine would probably do it, but like, or a back air, that works too. Oh. Yep, stall it out there. 1-1. We are back in it. Nice and even. It's gonna run it right back to Dreamland. It's kind of interesting that a Turbo let him actually. I think. Because they didn't play... They played Dreamland Game 1, right?
It's funny. We've been to... what? How many stages?
We've been to...
twice.
We've been to nearly every stage except, I think, Battlefield. Which is kind of...
I don't think they've gone final yet, have they?
I think... Or maybe they did go to Battlefield. Oh, yeah, they did. Maybe they haven't gone final. Well, it's kind of like what the reason that I said. It's not... So, it's in Eddie's interest to maybe go to FD... if he feels like that Turbo isn't going to chain grab him. It's in Turbo's interest to go to FD to chain grab him. But, like, that's very dependent on Turbo having, like, the chain grab knowledge and everything like that. It's a very risky stage in the matchup because you have to know certain things or the other character's probably going to body you. You have to respect certain things or the other character's probably going to body you.
Eddie brought back that stocky vest.
Oh, yeah, So I think that's kind of why we're seeing like a want to return to Dreamland and stuff like that, because it's kind of like Falco's next best option in the matchup, because you get more space if you want more space, but you also get like platforms and you get more of a technically as Fox you get more of a chance to have survivability, but you also get that with Falco in that you don't necessarily just get chain grabbed to death, because you can eventually escape the chain grab onto a platform and they have to sort of respond with a tech chase situation. Good back air.
Interesting momentum you got going here. I don't know, it feels kind of different.
Well, there's a lot of back and forth because of how volatile this matchup is. You see it with stuff like that up tilt there and that dare possibly ending it if it wasn't for that good tech to ledge there.
Oh,
Yeah, I think he held down and then held down and expected the opposite tech, but didn't hold down in the right way, so he just sort of air dodged off stage. That happens a lot. And he did it again. That is, I believe, 2-1 in favor of Turbo now.
I mean, I'm a novice. It happens to me all the time.
You got it's 2-1 you in the second set. It's two one Turbo in the second set. You have to win two games to win.
So they're going back to stadium.
Yeah, they're willing to. I mean, that's just showing a willingness to play on the stage, regardless of how the set count goes.
The outcome isn't dictated by the stage.
My God.
I'm sure we've had like three or four.
Oh my God. Wow.
That was a beautiful zero death right there.
So that's how we do it, man. This is Birdman's territory. Oh my God. He's looking like. Look. He is looking like a mini West Balls right now. But, you know, good shine to get out of there. It's, you know, resetting the neutral, getting yourself back in there. Only taking 9% so far, despite having put on 100. Oh, good shine. That'll kill you at, like, zero anyway. Yeah, especially Falco. Good down smash. It's just sort of making sure you can cover all the options there. Good back air. Again, like, you know, it goes to show how volatile this matchup is. You have to be aware of your opponent's placement on the stage at all times because they do have six blue lines. They will use them in some way and will lead to some sort of aerial follow-up. Like, most of the time with these two, it tends to be back air, nair, or in Fox's case, up air, in Falco's case, down air. Although you can technically drill shine against the walls here. Almost a good gimp, but got hit by the Firefox there. Yeah, very close there. All right. Eddie feeling it right now. He wants this to go to game five. He wants this to go to game five set two. He wants this to keep being a good set. He's making it work right now.
This is very interesting. I mean, as far as I know, last week, Turbo went on a rampage.
Was it like 9-1 like the entire like two tournaments? I think it was something like that. And that's pretty crazy. But definitely not looking that way this week. Much more of a making some mistakes that are a little bit costly. But Nap also looking better than he did last week. And looking better all the time. And that's really important. Getting that F smash. And that's game four. Now it's 2-2. This is
all right,
game
guys.
Five.
This is it. 2-2. After the bracket reset. So.
Of course, Eddie has no bans, so this is technically kind of the freest travel to. Oh, God.
Oh, boy.
I think we got our wish on like seeing how this matchup actually plays out on that stage. Though I feel like the actual response was probably to just straight go to Fountain, because it was pretty evident to me that Turbo had the advantage on Fountain by like a long shot. But now we have to get to see how this goes. Turbo definitely showing already. Up, oh, see,
the chain grabs.
He definitely has the chain grabs. See, I didn't know if he did. Now that I know that he does, this definitely looks a lot more of like something like Nap has to be aware of. It is not okay to get like a free 50% off here, but a good F tilt. Ooh, all right.
I don't know how many times we've booed in the hot over that.
Well, it's just like such a good reaction. Wow. All right. Looking like a Falco right now with that shine bear. Covering the options so well right now.
Turbo matching Eddie. That was a really good tech.
Ooh, all right, getting the nair. It's it's like I said, it's just a matter of trading hits. And this stage is just scary, especially because, again, yeah, he's going for the grab. Probably a little late on that to keep trying for that percentage there. Interesting reverse bear. Probably meant to nair, but had probably had a bit of a risk to do that too. Going a bit far for that one though, and turbo punishing that pretty efficiently. This matchup's very tricky because, you know, as you can see, anyone's game, anyone's punish.
We're literally stock for stock at the moment, and it's just,
and here we go. This is the Falco FD special, man. Well, Shine kind of stale there. Oh. Ooh! Eddie, yep, those pillars. All right. That's Eddie respecting that. And here it comes.
Comes the Falco train. But can Turbo bring it back?
There's actually a surprisingly good chance of that. Ooh! Trying to cover it. Maybe should have gone for upper, but double back air sealing the stock. It is last stock in this reset. And only thing that's kind of a problem is the reset, but holy crap, but Turbo keeps it right back up, and it is now dead even, and now he's head. Alright. Oh, he won't do it. Oh, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Oh. Get the reset, he got the grab, and oh, got the jab. Felt like that was an up smash. Oh
my.
Down smash.
I don't think my heart can take this.
Oh my god, the up air.
The pillar combo.
Ooh.
And that is it.
Ooh. That was off the worst hitbox of the down smash that could have happened. He probably should have gone for the suicide dare, but that was like, holy crap.
That was crazy.
Off the whiff, you got the up B to up air. That was absolutely crazy. What a way to end the tournament. Good shit to both these players.
So, yeah, I mean, and Turbo has the lead now. Turbo's got a win over.
He's
Eddie.
Now. Well, actually, if I'm thinking correctly, because the reset counts as like a set trade. So, Nap won winners finals. Then he reset grands. So it was 1-1. Then it was 2-1 Nap favor. Then Turbo won two straight sets because Nap didn't get the reset. So he was then up 3-2. I think that means that Turbo's up 5-3 because that means he won winners, right? He won winners. He lost that loser set, which means that it's then 4-3. But he just won that second grand set, so that's 5-3. So if he had lost that set, it would have been a tied 4-4 and been really interesting. But I don't know. That was crazy. That was absolutely crazy.
But that was exhilarating. And that last stretch right there was crazy.
Yeah.
Those down airs and just the Firefox.
Yeah.
Firefalco.
Absolutely crazy privilege to watch that set for those particular moments. They're looking hot right now.
All it takes is one up here.
All I really want to see at this point now is just to see Remo or Carlo Rossi come in and how that affects how things play out. Because I haven't seen Tony in a while. I feel like he and either of these two would have a close set. He would probably take it, but it would be a really close set. And so it would be entertaining to watch. Remo, I haven't a clue. So, anyway.
All right.
Good shit, Henry. Thanks for commentating with me.
Don, it's always a pleasure. And, yeah.
Shake my hand, you asshole.